Hey everyone, welcome to Intellipaat. In today's video, we're going to discuss about three of the most popular JavaScript framework and library for web development. That is Angular, React, and Vue.js. You all must be aware about their current recognition in the industry, right? Which one to choose, that is a question. So in the spirit of helping you decide, we'll talk about the same, that is Angular versus React versus Vue.js. But guys, before we move forward, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Now guys, let's have a look at the agenda for this video. So first and foremost, we'll discuss what exactly is Angular, what exactly is React, and what exactly is Vue.js. After that, we'll discuss few of the parameters based on which we'll differentiate between three of these technologies, right? Then we'll discuss the learning curve in them, that is the ease of learning, followed by the pros and cons of using each one of these technologies. Then we'll quickly look into the popularity and trends along with the technologies and the companies using them, right? And then finally, we'll conclude our video by discussing which one is better to choose. We'll also have a short quiz based on the video. Make sure to put down your answers in the comment section below to know if you're correct. Also guys, if you're looking to get certified in trending technologies, then do visit Intellipaat.com. Alright guys, now without any further ado, let's get started.
So what is Angular? Angular is a full-fledged MVC framework. Developers use Angular to build front-end applications, and Angular uses HTML as a templating language. It uses HTML to describe how the view should be structured, how the user would see the front-end of your application, and that is all taken care of by Angular. It parses the HTML and displays the view. On the other hand, React.js is not a full-fledged application framework. However, it's just a library that takes care of displaying the front end of your application based on the data and the template that you have provided. It does not take care of other tasks such as fetching the data from the backend server, validating the data, so on and so forth. So if you're looking for all the capabilities built in, then React.js is not completely for you. You can download and use other libraries or frameworks to perform these tasks. React.js is just concerned with displaying the front end of your application, which is why it's quite easier to understand React.js than Angular.js. On the other hand, Vue.js is also a JavaScript application framework. It uses the MVVM, which is the Model View View Model architectural style, rather than the MVC style, which is used by Angular. It is used to build the user interfaces of a front-end application. And unlike other monolithic frameworks such as Angular, Vue.js is designed to be learned from the basics, so you could adopt it step by step and incrementally incorporate it in your application. Now let's take a look at all of these technologies and compare them on several parameters. Let's take a look at the technology types. So MVC framework, Angular uses the MVC framework, and MVC basically is an architectural pattern which allows you to separate your code into models, views, and controllers. It's easier to take care of and manage your application when every component is separated in these categories. On the other hand, React.js is just a JavaScript library which is concerned with displaying the view or the user interface to the user. And Vue.js is the MVVM based JavaScript framework. It allows you to use the MVVM architectural pattern, which is quite similar to MVC. So if you are comfortable with using MVC, you could use Angular or you could adopt Vue.js without much hassle. Now let's take a look at the foundations of these frameworks. So Angular.js was created by Google in 2010, and since then Angular.js has went through a major revision. So since Angular version 2, Angular has been a complete rewrite of Angular.js. The version 1.x is now referred to as Angular.js and is still used by many of the applications that were written in it. However, Angular has moved away from that kind of architecture. And so if you are planning on learning Angular now, you should learn Angular rather than Angular.js, which is the previous version. On the other hand, Facebook developed React.js in 2013 for the sole purposes of making it easier for building front-end applications and displaying the user interface to the user. And Vue.js was created by a former Google employee. His name is Ivan Yu. And he also worked on a lot of Angular.js projects, and he wanted to build a framework that was very much like Angular, however much easier to adopt and use. Now let's take a look at the languages used by these frameworks and libraries. So Angular.js uses TypeScript. TypeScript is just a superscript of JavaScript, which is basically any valid JavaScript is valid TypeScript. TypeScript can be thought of as JavaScript with some added functionalities, such as type hints describing what the parameters the functions will take in, what kinds of parameters they will be, and what kinds of parameters will be outputted by a function. On the other hand, we have React.js, which uses JavaScript and JSX. JSX is nothing but an XML or HTML-like syntax which is used by React. So instead of you having to write some large block of JavaScript code to describe your user interface and nesting those blocks to create a hierarchy of user interfaces, you could just write HTML-like syntax and that will be converted by JSX into JavaScript, which will then be interpreted by React.js and displayed on the web browser. And Vue.js is very much like Angular.js. It uses JavaScript. However, it's possible to use TypeScript with Vue.js as well as React.js. However, these frameworks by default use JavaScript and JSX in React's case. So if you want to use JavaScript and then move on to TypeScript, you could use Vue.js. However, Angular comes pre-bundled with TypeScript and you have to use TypeScript with Angular.js. Very much like Angular, JavaScript framework Vue also uses HTML for describing its user interface, and it contains everything that your front-end components might need in a single file. So if you have been creating a front-end component for a form, all the HTML, all the CSS, and all the JavaScript will be contained in a single file, which is called the Vue component file. Now let's take a look at debugging and testing capabilities. Since Angular is a full-fledged front-end framework, it comes with a pre-bundled debugging and testing frameworks. So it allows you to write tests out of the box without having to do much configurations. On the other hand, React.js is quite open to any sort of testing framework that you want to use. Just make sure you understand how to integrate it with React.js. One of the popular frameworks for React.js testing is Enzyme, which is created by the company Airbnb. And very much like Angular, here also Vue.js comes with pre-built testing and debugging functionalities. It integrates well with several platforms and allows you to write tests that can verify your application is working properly. Now let's take a look at data binding. Data binding is simply the property of an application which makes sure that whenever the data changes, any component of your view or the user interface that is displaying that data updates automatically. So Angular.js uses Angular.js is using the two-way data binding, and for two-way data binding basically means that when you change the data, it is displayed on the user interface, and when the when the user changes the data, that change is reflected in the code as well. On the other hand, takes a completely different approach. It uses one-way data binding, so it only allows changes in data to be bound to the UI elements, and the reverse is not possible. So the reason why this is done is because React.js is based on the fundamental principle of one-way data flow. That makes your application more predictable, and changes in data will create changes in the user interface and not the other way around, and that makes your application easier to understand, test, and debug, which is why React.js is so popular. And much like Angular, Vue.js also uses the two-way data binding. It uses the vModel directive to create these bindings. Now let's take a look at the latest versions or the latest stable versions available of these application frameworks or libraries. So for Angular, the latest stable version is 8.2.14 as of now. React.js is on its 16th version, 16.12.0. And Vue.js is on its second version, so it's the latest stable version is 2.6.11. Now let's take a look at the syntax of these languages. As you can see, Angular uses TypeScript, so it contains a lot of decorators and extra features that are not available in JavaScript. When you look at any JavaScript code that contains @, such as the @ component, that's a directive, that is a feature that is provided by TypeScript. And as you can see, the code, when you look at the Angular code, it's quite involved and it's not as easy to understand. As you can see, we have React code as well, and it's quite easy to understand because it's only concerned with displaying the user interface. It appears to be returning some HTML string, but as discussed earlier, this is not HTML. This is JSX, which is then converted into a JavaScript object, which is then displayed by React.js and managed by React.js as well. And this is what a Vue application looks like. It's creating an HTML template, and then you inside the JavaScript, it creates a new instance of the Vue class. It binds the element to an HTML template, which the ID of app, and displays the message hello Vue.js. And as you can see in the output, it displays hello Vue.js. Now let's take a look at the learning curve, how difficult or easy it might be for you to pick up these languages, frameworks, and libraries. So for Angular.js, there is a lot of training available. However, it's going to be more involved since it's a full-fledged application framework. It takes care of a lot of things. So you'll have to understand the architecture and all of the components associated with Angular.js. To work with Angular.js, you need to know TypeScript. You need to understand what MVC is, and then different components of Angular such as directive, modules, services, components, routing, so on and so forth. On the other hand, to use Vue and React, you could easily adopt these technologies. They are quite easier to learn than Angular. You could use the TypeScript language with these frameworks as well. However, they give you the opportunity to use JavaScript at the beginning, and you can convert then JavaScript to TypeScript. So to learn React.js, you need to know the React framework, the JSX language or the JSX syntax, and it's very similar to XML. So if you know XML or HTML, JSX would be quite easier to pick up. On the other hand, we have Vue, and Vue also uses JavaScript and allows you to write code in that and HTML as well. Both of these frameworks also have components and routing. These are not pre-built into React, so you could download another packages like React Router, so on and so forth, to add these capabilities as you need them. You don't need to learn routing right up front to make a web application, such as you might need to do in Angular. Now let's take a look at pros and cons of each technology. So the pros of using Angular. The code written in Angular is cleaner, more structured. Angular offers higher performance. That depends on how you write the code and if you're following the best practices outlined in the documentation. But if you do follow them, then you will get pretty good performance. Error handling is also done in Angular.js for you. So you could just describe your error handlers and Angular.js will take care of mapping those errors and error handlers for you. Angular.js can be used to create material design like interfaces. Material design is the design language that was created by Angular, and Angular.js is easy to incorporate these material design interfaces. And Angular.js takes care of routing. So for instance, if you wish your application to display one page and when the user clicks on a link, we want it to display some other page, that takes routing and Angular.js takes care of it for you. So you won't have to make changes in your application and create your own routing logic. Angular.js comes pre-bundled with it. Now let's take a look at cons of using Angular. It's difficult to learn. It's got a steep learning curve. There's a lot of things that you need to learn to get started. It's sometimes slow. So depending on how you are writing your application, how you're nesting these components, how you are making sure the data binding is used and then released, these are all the things that could affect your application. And if you're not careful, your application might end up being quite slow. It might be difficult to integrate some packages with Angular because Angular has a specific structure and you need to understand how to integrate them in your Angular application. And it's difficult to switch. When you're writing an application in Angular and for some reason you need to switch it from Angular to any other framework, the code might be difficult to extract core logic from your application because of all the directives and HTML tags that it uses. Now let's take a look at pros of using React.js. So React.js has a better user experience. It's easier to develop a frontend in React.js because it's easier to use. It's easy to launch and develop. So if you're planning on building a React.js application, you'd be amazed at how easy it is to build and launch an application in React.js. It's more time saving than Angular because you don't have to learn all of these fundamental concepts that you need to learn in Angular. It's stability of code because of one-way data binding. So as discussed earlier, Facebook adopted one-way data binding for React.js mainly because it makes your code more stable, easier to reason, easier to understand, and easier to debug. And it also allows you to use third-party libraries. This is easier to integrate third-party libraries with React.js because it does not come pre-packaged with solutions to perform all the tasks. Let's take a look at cons of using React. If you wish to integrate React with other traditional MVC frameworks like Ruby on Rails and any other framework that you can think of, it could be difficult to set up the complex configuration and use them in conjunction with each other. And React.js users are also expected to have in-depth knowledge of integrating with MVC frameworks. This is why when you're using React, you should make sure that you completely understand the JavaScript language as well as the backend framework that you're using to create your application. Now let's take a look at the pros of using Vue.js. Vue.js is quite small in footprint, so your application will not have a lot of baggage when it comes to using Vue.js. You can incrementally adopt it. It's quite easy to understand, relatively easier than Angular.js. It's quite simple to integrate in your application. You just need to drop in the library link and then start using it. It's very flexible, allows you to use different components, different frameworks, libraries with itself, and allows you to structure your code however you wish to. It provides great tooling. So if you're using Vue.js, you could use a lot of tools that you wish to use to make your application development easier. And it allows your code to be more readable. Now let's take a look at cons of using Vue.js. So it's got quite a small community. So if you're wondering if you have a large community of developers that can help you out if you ever stuck in a problem, that might not be the case with Vue.js. It has lack of plugins. So if you are wondering if you could just download and install and integrate some plugins, you might be out of luck depending on whether the plugin is available or not because of the smaller size of the Vue.js community. And finally, over flexibility. So as we discussed, Vue.js is quite flexible. However, that flexibility comes at a cost. So you need to understand how to use that flexibility and how not to write code that's using the flexibility in the wrong way and making your application slower or badly structured. So when you take a look at GitHub and you search for Angular, you get around 500,000 or 600,000 repository results. React.js has almost the double results, which is over 1 million. And as Vue.js has a smaller community, it only has 327,000 results. This displays the popularity, but let's take a look at the trends. So as you can see, React.js has been quite popular for quite some time. On the other hand, Angular.js is quite close to React.js and Vue.js is not that popular because of the smaller community size. So let's take a look at the companies using these technologies. Angular.js is used by Google, obviously, because Google has created this. Then it's Sony, Nike, Forbes, and many other companies are using Angular.js. On the other hand, React.js is used by Facebook, it's used by Instagram, it's used by Airbnb, Netflix, and WhatsApp. React.js is used by these companies to build the front end of their application. Let's take a look at Vue.js. So Facebook has used Vue.js to build some parts of its application. Netflix is also using Vue.js. Adobe has used Vue.js for building its portfolio site. MI, which is a popular cell phone provider company, it uses Vue.js as well. And the Alibaba group uses Vue.js as well. So the question that comes in our mind is, which one is better? Which one is more suited for you? Which one should you use? That totally depends on your experience, the project that you're trying to build, and your comfort with the syntax and terminologies of these languages. So if you wish to use Angular, React, or Vue, or you wish to choose between one of these, I would suggest that you take a look at each one of them, try them out, build quite small projects with them to get a feel of how these frameworks work, and the one that feels most natural or comfortable to you, choose that framework. Make sure that you understand the pros and cons of choosing one over the other. For instance, if you want every possible functionality that you might need pre-bundled in your framework, then Angular is a better choice. Then comes Vue and then comes React. So it totally depends on how you want to structure your application and how comfortable are you with these technologies. So take a look at each one of them and figure out which one works best for you and for your project requirements. And finally, as discussed, we have the question for the quiz. Which one of these technologies supports one-way data binding? Is it Angular? Is it React? Vue.js? Or is it all of the above? So you could mention the answers in the comment section below.
So guys, that's all for today. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any further queries, you can let us know in the comment section below. We will reach out to you immediately. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. See you again. Thank you.